And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. We're now at the final stage of the game, the barrel stage. It is also the hardest game. So don't expect that I will beat this stage in this video. We have of course already seen a little bit of the barrel stage, and I actually made quite a lot of progress last time. However, it's been a while since I recorded the previous video, and therefore I have rusted a little bit. And we are dead. This is okay. The main difficulty here, it's probably quite obvious from the video itself, but in case it's not, I'm going to explain it anyway. It's the fact that these barrels always come in pairs. Well, they mostly come in pairs, and it's very hard not to get hit by the second barrel. For instance, as you saw there, I jumped too early, and then I did the same mistake again. If you think that there is only one barrel that's coming and you jump too early, you will simply jump right into the second barrel. Okay. One objectively bad design of the game is that in contrast to the Jekyll stages, which do have a significant difficulty progression, the Hyde stages in fact do not. Also, one thing that you can do is you can simply wait for basically the barrel spawning to subside. If you wait long enough, it should always be possible to basically wait out all the barrels. Well, that's a theory at least. Okay. So maybe patience is in fact the key here. So we will try this strategy. We will try to emphasis on trying here. We'll try to wait for all these barrels to come by. By the way, I'm playing this on an emulator, in case you didn't notice. And I'm also using, well, not an NES controller, which would not be possible per se, given that I'm playing on an emulator. I mean, people have probably modded their NES controllers and designed adapters, custom adapters for them, that you can play with an NES controller on a PC. But I did no such thing. I'm playing this with an Xbox controller. Xbox 360, that is. Okay, the barrels have stopped now. Maybe we can make it past her. Yeah, we can. Okay, so... shit. Okay. And I... lost my concentration there for a moment. Okay, we just force you to drop that. We got hit by that anyway. Probably should have jumped over the barrel. Okay. Okay, now we are dead and have lost all our precious progress. I mean, it is, after all, the last stage of the game. So it's supposed to be difficult. And I completely forgot to start my timer. Yeah. Okay, so now I don't... So this video won't be exactly 15 minutes long. Probably more like 25 minutes. Okay. But I think that's the strategy that we have adopted here, that is to wait out these barrels, seems to have worked for the most part. However, I mean, it does require a lot of patience, and to be frank, yeah. It's probably more sensical just to wait until basically there's an opening, so to speak, in the oncoming in the wave of oncoming barrels. Okay. Okay, we've made it this far. So far, I am playing this on an emulator. So far, I didn't really, take any advantage of this fact, meaning that I didn't really use save states except for the purpose of saving the game, because I'm not recording these videos all in one run. I actually don't know whether this game... Well, I mean, I guess... Yeah, this doesn't actually have any save future, but you could... well, maybe it did, actually. So... some of these NES games had... some non-volatile memory that was powered by battery included, like... I mean, the best example would probably be the Zelda games, which quite obviously you can't just complete in one setting, so... do not get killed by the stairs. And so perhaps also Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde had such a battery-powered memory. I don't know. But in any case, I mean, if you want to beat this game, you can just, I guess, not turn off your NES. And this was stupid of me. Okay. And this is... You think this is some sort of boss, but... No, she's just a regular enemy. This game, in fact, has two endings. So, apparently, which ending you will get depends on the actions that you will take. I think that you need to get far enough as Hyde in order to get the good ending. Okay, I need to concentrate now. Okay. We will just wait until these barrels have subsided. And I think they have stopped now. Okay, then. We're very careful, we can... Make it through here. Okay. Okay, now the dog. Okay, so force him to do that. And then hopefully, okay. So he does respawn. Okay. Now what? Well, that wasn't quite what I intended to do. But I guess if I survive this, then it's... will also work out. Okay. Well, if I survive that, which is a big if... So my idea was actually to go into this door. And I was lucky that I wasn't hit there. But no such... No cigar. No such cigar here. Okay. Yeah, but I much prefer playing the barrel stage. As opposed to playing the third stage. Because the beginning of the third stage is way harder, in my opinion, than even this. Okay, this was stupid. Okay, Can I? No. Okay. Shit. Okay, one more hit, I think, and I'm dead. Shit. Well, I guess two more hits, and I'm... Okay, this is where, as I mentioned earlier, the game starts, to throw enemies at you that come from behind. But still, the Hyde stages are nothing in comparison to the Jekyll stages in terms of difficulty. The only thing that I'm worried about is that we will eventually run out of, well, If we get too far as height, we basically lose the ability to regain health, then I don't know, yeah, whether it's possible to beat this stage. I mean, we'd have to do this without dying. Which is in theory possible, but yeah, I don't know. Okay, shit. Okay. Okay. Shit. Okay, so it is possible to dodge the initial attack of this woman, given, given enough luck. So, didn't really dodge that consciously, but I just happened to be in the right spot. Okay. You don't get killed by the stair glitch. Okay. This was quite good. Yeah, and I think there are no more barrels spawning until we have made it past this woman. Well, I was wrong, in fact. To the surprise of absolutely no one. Okay. Shit. Ah, fuck. Sometimes my controller does not register. Maybe it's a problem with my controller. Or it's a problem with... Shit. Okay. Or it's a problem with the emulator. In any case, this isn't actually that bad. Mainly because... Well, this is... Shit. Okay. Shit. Concentrate here. Shit, and this is Okay, the game glitched out there for a moment. And because I didn't really pay attention, because I got distracted, yeah. We have lost all this progress again. And I think this is a good time to stop this video, and when we'll come back, folks, more of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. So until next time, until then.